Let's make this Excel dashboard using slicers, data bars, shapes, column charts, and pivot tables. I'm going to the upper left and I am choosing a color theme to make it easy so that I'm always picking colors within the theme. So I went with shades of blue, but pick whatever makes sense for you. Then we need to do some titling here and some formatting of cell colors. So I'm going to fill a darker blue at the top. And then next, I'm going to pick some cells and I'm going to do a lighter blue. Again, if you notice, all of these are shades of blue because they're all within our color formatting or our brand colors that we chose. Now, when we enter our title, we need to format this. We need to make it larger. We really want it to stand out, and then we can bold it and we can turn the font color white. Let's add a subheading here so that it's really clear what we're looking at. Change these to whatever makes sense for you. And then let's format this one as well. And we're going to change the color on that to white and make it larger and bold it as well, because we really, again, want this to stand out. Let's change that font size. And then we need to insert some shapes. So let's go to insert shape and we're going to do a rectangle with rounded edges. So select that and then we're going to draw it in. We need to then move it in place and we can change the color here. Let's change it to a lighter gray. We're going with like a gray and blue themed dashboard. We'll move it into place right around column H. It doesn't really matter exactly where, you'll need to just space it however is appropriate. Now we are going to add more of these, so keep that in mind for the size that you're using. And then let's go in and add a line. We want to put a dividing line in here because we are going to include icons to the left to make it really easy to see what these numbers are. Using the icons is a cool way to avoid having to use more words, and it just makes it easier to look at. So now we've got our line in there. You can click on this and format it more if you like, but we're going to copy and paste these by clicking on both items while holding shift and then moving them into place here. And we will need a fourth one, so we're going to scroll over and then move that if needed just a little bit. Now that looks good. So now we've got our four metric windows up at the top. I'm going to scroll back over and move this one. It's actually up a little bit higher than it needs to be. So then next what we need to do is go back up to the top ribbon and we need to go to icons. So we're inserting icons. And what you can do here is type in whatever you're looking for. So let's say the first one is we want a phone. And we're going to click on that, and then you can go back to that search field and then enter in a target, because let's say, you know, accepted calls is our target. And then you can do something like a prize or an award. And then if you wanted money or something to signify value, you could add that. I double clicked on accident, and so you leave the window. So you have to go back into insert icon. Now I can type that in again and select the one. There's actually not really a great one for money, but we'll use the stacks of bars of gold. So then we can separate these, and if you hit shift or control and select all of them, you can resize them all at one time. So we'll try doing that, and then just using those upper right circles. And if that works, that's great, but you might have to do some more resizing. So then what we're going to do is move these into place where they need to go. So the first one is the phone. The second one is going to be where the target goes or our accepted calls. And then this is going to be our deals. And then at the very end is where we want to put our values. And so I am going to pause here and fix these up and save you time. And now I'm back. So now we're back in our data and we're selecting everything and we're going to press Control T because we need to turn this into a table. And then let's go to the upper left here and name this sales data. This will make this easier to work with. And then we're going to insert a pivot table. So we inserted the pivot on a new sheet. And so I'm just going to rename it. I recommend you do that. The more sheets and tabs you have, the more difficult it is to keep track. So then we need to make sure that we check these boxes for the appropriate fields. These are our four main metrics. I'm going to move values into rows. And so far, this is looking pretty good. So we do need to format these though. So we want these to be a number, and then the bottom one is going to need to be currency. So we want this to make sense. So let's click on this and hit the dollar sign for currency, and then we're going to remove two of the decimal places just to make it easier to look at. And so now we're going to click here and insert slicer. These are going to be your buttons, that you click when you want to see the individual information for the various reps. So we just need to resize that a little bit, and then you can change this to whatever color theme makes sense. So we'll go with that darker blue. Now I'm pressing Control X, and then I'm going over to our dashboard and I hit Control V to paste it in place. And you can just move it to wherever makes sense. And now let's go back to our ribbon at the top, and we're going to insert a shape because we want a text option. So we're drawing this in place, and we don't want that to be that dark, so we will change that. But right now we're linking to the cells. So you want to link to the cell that is appropriate. You're in a pivot table though, so you actually need to go in and click on the cell just to the right of the pivot table and then adjust the cell as needed so that there's no more formula. So now you've got your linked call information. So now every time you adjust these buttons, your data is going to update for you automatically. So let's do some formatting. We're going to make this bigger. We want to center it. We're going to center it both horizontally and vertically so that it's really nice and easy to look at. And then that's looking pretty good. We've got a couple more things to do here. We want to change this so that there is no border around it. And now it looks good. So now we need to do the same thing because we want to put underneath here what this is. So it's calls. We do have our icon, but just to be extra super clear, we're going to add one word or two words underneath each one. So then we can format this as well. And so we're going to change the font size on that. Let's make it bold. And let's center again horizontally and vertically. And then we changed it to white so it really stands out. But actually, if we're going to change this and make this the same as the light gray, maybe we should actually go back to black. So all you need to do is click on it again and change it to black. So this is starting to come together. However, our number doesn't have a comma, so we must have made a mistake. So we need to go back to our pivot table and make sure that you have a comma in the number. So by clicking on the comma and then changing the decimals, looks good. Whatever you have on that other tab is what's going to carry through on this tab. So you can't fix it here. You need to fix it on the pivot table tab. So now what we're going to do is we're going to copy and paste all that information because it's already centered. It's already got the wording. We've already drawn in the text box. So we're keeping all these text boxes the same size. And then what we want to do is we need to relink these cells. So we're going to need to click on each one, each number, and we're going to just need to adjust these. These were in rows, so if you're started with row 4, you can just do 5, 6, 7 as you're going here. But as you notice, the format started to get weird again. So we will need to go back and fix that. Let's change our words underneath each one to make sure that they match the appropriate cell from the pivot table. And then what we're going to do is we want to use the Format Painter. So we're going to click on our first one because that's done properly, and then click on that Format Painter, and it's going to copy the exact format you have and then paste it for you on each one that you click. So now what we want to do is hit one of these shapes, hit Control A, and it's going to select all of them. And then we need to check that little radio button there because we don't want these cell sizes to adjust. So now we're going to go back to our table information, and we need to do a pivot table again. So this time we're going to do it on existing, and we want to put it on our dashboard so that it's actually there. So we inserted it on existing and we chose this. We needed to resize our names down a little bit, but all is looking good. So make sure again, you click these main headings and that they're in the values field. And then we need to drag name down because we want name on here and all of the information. So now we're going to select everything and let's change this color. We want it to be that background blue that we had. So we might need to make some adjustments here. We could change the whole rest of this blue now that we know how long our name list is going to be in our slicer. And now it's all the same color. So I need to adjust these, but I can't yet. What I need to do is remove some of. The titles are going to look a lot nicer, so press Control H and hit some of, and then let's leave that next field blank because we want to replace some of with blanks to make these titles look nicer. And then let's close that out, and we're going to highlight all of this, and we're going to go to conditional formatting, but flip over to the next video to get the second part.